I started seeing ads for that new the new 007 movie. Can't wait for that, right, fellas? Oh, yeah. You gotta love that, boy. Don't you hate when you anticipate a movie's gonna be really good and you get all into it? Like Ransom. I thought Ransom was gonna be a great movie because it had a great trailer. Remember, they took his son. You know, he wants to get his son back. He can't get his son back. Where is his son? He's gotta find him. Remember the end of the trailer? He's on the phone. He goes, "Give me back my son!" And you wanted to see that movie. Then you went to see it and you walked out of the theater going, "Give me back my money!" I mean, it just costs too much to go to the movies and be experimenting. Especially when, like, when you're running late and you gotta get food at the theater, we'll just eat there. All right, you had a couple colossal dogs, you had the jumbo popcorn, large cherry Coke, small diet Coke, and a milk duds. Be 116.22. And guys, that's when your date pipes up, right? "I might have that 22 cent. That's a bitter laugh, but we've all been there. All right, ladies, meet us halfway. Bring your purse, but bring the biggest purse you got. Because we love sneaking food into the movies, right, guys? Oh, that's all. Oh, guys, love that. Mm-hmm. Yeah, might not be a good movie, but we gonna eat good, I tell you that much. Yeah, uh-huh. You need them shrimps. I'm gonna need something to cook them with, too. By the time we get done, you can't even carry your purse through the parking lot. You're dragging it. Go on and get the tickets. I'll catch up. Just go on. I love it. I think going to the movies is like one of the sweetest things you can do on a date. It always will be. You know, it's just kind of nice. Sit in the dark, you can hold hands, get hugged up. You know, it's nice. You take your girl out to the movies, right? Guys, you go, "Hey, dinner and a movie. A nice traditional evening out, sweetheart. Hey, taking you out. Dinner and a movie, whatever you want to see, whatever you want to eat, it's all, nah, whatever you want. Whatever. No. Whatever you want to eat. Whatever, I don't care. I'm up for something chicken-y, but whatever. No, you pick. No, whatever you want to see. No, I don't care. No. That? It's about you. The mirror has two faces. I've been meaning to check that out. My buddies wanted me to go with them. No, I saved it for you. You know, that's cool. All the guys standing in line looking at each other. Watching the guys that went out together in a group coming out of their movie, like a Steven Seagal movie or whatever, going, "That was bad! That was bad! Oh, I love that dude, man! Oh, that was bad! What was bad? What was bad? What'd he do? We don't even know what we're going to see. Now, get up to the window. Hi, let me have two for the mirror has face magnolia steel truth about to exhale luck club, whatever. So I'm looking forward to the 007. Don't you love it? Oh man. 007, coolest dude ever, man. Every time there's a new 007, because what's his name is a new guy. Every time there's a new guy, people start giving him a hard time. You know what I mean? You hear guys sitting in the theater, "Man, this dude ain't that cool, man. I don't even like this dude, man. He ain't even as cool as Roger Moore. He definitely knows Sean Connery, man. See, this guy, man, shut up. He a better one you'll ever be. Watch the movie." Every guy's fantasy, that's all there is to it. Every guy's jealous, because every guy thinks he wants to be the next 007. I ain't no different. I want to be the next 007. I want to be the first black 007. Oh. Bond. Jamal. Bond. Enough said, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks a lot. You're very kind. Thank you. And good night.